Hi, I'm Benedict Su from Sophos Support, and today I will be talking about setting up scanning exclusions for Sophos Central endpoints. Adding scanning exclusions is the easiest way for customers to allow blocked applications, websites, or potentially unwanted applications, also known as PUA. I will show you how we can achieve this under different Sophos components from your Central console. We will be focusing on setting up the exclusions for Windows platforms today. Please note, before adding any scanning exclusions, make sure the applications or websites you plan to exclude are trustworthy. There are many exclusion types, but we will discuss the most common ones. First, we have file or folder exclusions. These omit the main files or folders of an application from real-time scanning or scheduled scanning. This can be used for incorrectly detected applications or exclusions recommended by some vendors for optimal performance. Next, are process exclusions. Like the previous type, these exclude the main executables of an application from scanning. Website exclusions allow access to sites blocked by Sophos Labs. We generally do not recommend using these unless we are certain that the site is not malicious in nature. This type can also be used to exclude internal websites from scanning to improve performance. Website exclusions are not to be confused with web control, which is a separate Sophos feature that blocks some sites based on its category. We've linked a separate video in the description covering this. Lastly, we have PUA exclusions. As mentioned before, PUA stands for Potentially Unwanted Applications. These are programs that are not malicious, but are generally considered unsuitable for most business networks, such as remote administration and hacking tools. Some common PUAs are PSExec, PSQ, and other third-party and self-developed applications. Now we will cover some exclusion types that are specific to Intercept X. The first one is detected exploits. We can add exclusions if a trusted application was detected and blocked. The next one is the exploit mitigation. Some applications may not be detected and blocked, but will still be affected by scanning, causing degraded performance. You can add applications here to prevent this from happening. The last type is ransomware protection. Sometimes, legitimate applications may be detected as ransomware due to their questionable behavior. We can add either the name of the process or the folder path to be excluded from the detection. Variable and wildcards. When adding scanning exclusions for different Sophos components, it is important to use system variables and wildcards, especially when we are excluding files from shared location or app path changes for different logon users. Sophos Central Endpoint employs two different sets. For real-time scanning exclusions, Windows variable and wildcards are used. And for Intercept X exclusions, a different set is used. For more information, refer to the documentation linked in the description. Now let's create some scanning exclusions. We have the option to create exclusions that affects all users and devices, or only specific users and devices. To allow an application, website or PUA for all users and devices, we can add scanning exclusions within global settings. Global exclusions, and select Add Exclusion. In the pop-up window, choose the exclusion type. We will first cover file or folder for Windows. Here we simply add in the path to a file or folder that we want to exclude. Make sure that if you are adding a folder exclusion, you add a child-link slash to the path to make sure it is active for real-time scans, scheduled scans, or both. Next is website exclusion. We will select Add Exclusion again. Under the drop-down, select Website, Mac or Windows. Then we will type the URL or IP address that we wish to exclude and select Add. Now we will look at PUA exclusions. Select Add Exclusion. Under the drop-down, click Potentially Unwanted Application. PUAs are excluded by the name of the detection, such as PSQ, PSExec, and so on. Here, we will type the name of the PUA and select Add to allow it. Additionally, we will link a search tool in the description where you can look up specific PUAs for more information about them. Moving on to intercept X exclusions, adding them is almost identical to scanning exclusions. Let's start with adding an exclusion. Then we will choose our exclusion type. In this case, it's detected exploits. Here, we see a list of all exploits that have been detected and the associated device and user. We can select our desired events and select Add to add the exclusion. If we change the exclusion type to exploit mitigation, we will see a list of applications. Select the application that we want to allow, and we will be presented with a list of exploits that are being checked. We recommend only excluding the specific mitigations causing issues and leaving the rest enabled, which will require some testing. For applications that are not detected, you can select Application Not Listed and type in the path to the application. For non-detected applications, you only have the option to disable exploit mitigation completely, so use caution when allowing applications. Lastly, we will look at ransomware protection. After adding an exclusion, select ransomware protection from the dropdown. Here, we can either select a process or folder exclusion and then type the path of the process or folder. Again, make sure that you have a trailing slash if the path is a folder, so it targets the folder. Once done, you can add the exclusion. Make sure that you save the policy. If you only need to add exclusions for specific users or devices, we can add them via the threat protection policy. Go to Endpoint Protection, Policies, and click on Base Policy, Threat Protection. Use the clone option to duplicate the base policy and give it a name. Under Type, choose either user or device depending on what you need. Add the relevant users or devices to it. Then go to Settings, Exclusions, and choose Add Exclusion. You can then select the type of exclusion that you would like to make. After creating the exclusion, make sure that you save the policy by scrolling back to the top and selecting Save in the top right. If you are making separate policy for server, the process would be the same, but you will perform this under the Server Protection tab instead. An additional thing to note is that you will not be able to target specific users when creating a server policy. I hope you found this video useful. Let us know by giving us thumbs up on TechWeeks, and let us know if we resolved your issue. Check out the documentation for this video in the video description. For further assistance, view and post questions on community.sophos.com. And go to TechWeeks.sophos.com for more great videos like this one. See you next time!